Water, the essence of life on Earth, is under threat. The Third World War, many fear, will be for this precious depleting natural resource. World over, fresh water resources are increasingly becoming scarce, challenging the very existence of civilization. Already, 40% of the world's population is one way or the other affected by the shortage of water. The deepening crisis has cast its shadow on agriculture, which uses nearly 90% of the available water. By the middle of this century, another 3 billion people will be added to the existing population. That means 80% increase in water requirement for irrigation. This explains the urgent need to maximize the use of our available water resources in agriculture. We have no option but to save water on a war footing. India faces an increased competition for water between agriculture and non-agricultural sectors. The share of water for agriculture is set to reduce from 90% at present to 75 to 80% in the coming decade. A crisis that makes efficient management of water resources all the more crucial. Sustained efforts in this direction over the years have given birth to new technologies. These in turn have not only helped in water management, but also improved the quality and quantity of agricultural produce. The effectiveness of micro irrigation has contributed to its popularity in the cultivation of onion and garlic. The country on an average produces nearly 80 lakh tons of onion every year. The annual production of garlic stands at around 6 lakh tons. However, the productivity of these two horticultural products is not very encouraging. The average yield for onion stands at 14 tons per hectare. In the case of garlic, the average productivity is 4.5 tons per hectare. The reasons for this low productivity are manifold: inherent low yield potential of short-day Indian varieties, traditional and suboptimal cultivation practices, high incidence of pests and diseases, and shortage of irrigation water at critical growth stage. Given the demand for onion and garlic in the country, it is important to find ways to increase both their production and productivity. The use of improved agronomic practices, especially improved irrigation methods, could go a long way in achieving this objective. Flood irrigation presently is the most common method for onion and garlic. This inefficient use of water resources gives rise to a variety of losses through deep percolation, distribution loss, and evaporation. Micro irrigation primarily includes two innovative and effective irrigation techniques: the drip irrigation and the micro sprinkler irrigation. Onion and garlic are bulb vegetables. Both these crops are very shallow rooted. Their root system is normally restricted to 15 to 20 centimeters under the soil. This makes them very sensitive to moisture stress conditions during bulb initiation and development stages. Frequent and light irrigation at uniform intervals through micro irrigation results in good bulb development and increased yield in both crops. Drip irrigation optimizes the use of irrigation water by providing it uniformly and directly to the roots of the plants through a closed network of plastic pipes. The nutrients can also be supplied with irrigation water. Micro irrigation maximizes the use of water by ensuring that water reaches straight to the root area of the crop. Besides saving water and nutrients, the technique ensures several benefits in production, making farming cost-effective and environment-friendly. First and foremost, it saves water to the tune of 30 to 40%. It increases the quantity of marketable produce by around 15 to 20%. There is also a marked improvement in the quality of the produce. There is minimum incidence of pests and diseases, reduction in weed population, and ease in system operation. It saves precious money and physical labor, and from that we may get higher returns per unit area, per unit time. The major components of drip irrigation are pumps, main lines, filters, sub main lines, laterals, drippers or emitters. The layout of a drip irrigation system in a particular field requires proper planning, and it depends on the topography, crop geometry, water quality and soil type of the area. The installation begins with a graphic layout design showing the exact position of main line, sub main line, laterals and drippers. After this, the field is trenched to lay the main and the sub main lines. This is followed by fixing of the laterals and drippers. The filtration unit and the pumping unit are installed as per the layout design. A fertigation unit is also a part of the systems if the fertilizer and nutrients are to be supplied along with the water. This method allows applying the nutrients exactly and uniformly only to the wetted root volume where the active roots are concentrated. It is farmer friendly, nutrient and water saving, most effective and efficient method of applying fertilizers. Once the installation is complete, the system should be tested. The process for this involves: first, clean the entire system using water at a high pressure. Then, flow the water through the system with the desired pressure level to check the valves. The filtration unit and the fertigation unit should also be thoroughly checked. A drip irrigation system can be trouble-free and very reliable if the components used for making it are of the best quality and the design is well planned. However, routine inspection and preventive maintenance ensures that the system never malfunctions. The process of inspection involves checking for leakage from pipes, valves or any fittings, pressure in the system at various points, declogging of water in the pipes to ensure that it flows freely, manual flushing of lines to remove impurities. All these steps are essential to ensure that adequate water reaches the roots at all times to maximize the benefits of the system. Sprinkler method of irrigation is carried out through the network of pipes under pressure and sprayed in the air, which falls back on the crop like rain. The essential components of a sprinkler system include sprinklers or nozzles, main, sub-main and lateral pipelines, pipe fittings and accessories, and pumping unit. Sprinklers are broadly classified into long-range sprinklers, mini or micro sprinklers, and microjet sprinklers. The choice of a sprinkler type depends on the shape and size of the field, the soil type, and the water requirement of the crop. Each BBF consists of two drip laterals of 16 mm size with inbuilt emitters. After successful installation of micro irrigation systems, well-grown onion seedlings and selected mother cloves of garlic were planted at a spacing of 10 into 15 centimeters in a broad-based furrow or BBF of 120 centimeters top width, with 45 centimeters furrow maintaining a 15 centimeter height. Distances between two inbuilt emitters should be around 50 centimeters and the discharge flow rate should be 4 liters per hour. Of sprinkler irrigation, the distance between two laterals of micro sprinklers should be 6 meters and with a discharge rate of 135 liters per hour. The drip and sprinkler should be operated on alternate days based on daily pan evaporation rate. The operating pressure of drip system should be 1 kilogram per centimeter square and rotary micro sprinkler should be 1.5 kilogram per centimeter square. That application of nitrogen, phosphorus, potash in a ratio of 50:50:80 kilograms per hectare as basal and 100 kilogram nitrogen in onion, and in case of garlic, application of nitrogen, phosphorus, potash in a ratio of 50:50:50 kilograms per hectare as basal and 50 kilogram nitrogen through urea in 7 splits through drip was found most economical without compromising yield and quality. Micro irrigation techniques have greatly benefited the farming of onion and garlic. The results of micro irrigation experiment at the Directorate of Onion and Garlic Research, Rajguru Nagar, Pune, indicated that the highest marketable bulb yield in onion was 39.6 tons per hectare and garlic 13.2 tons per hectare under drip irrigation at 100% pan evaporation. From the experiment, it was observed that the percentage of A-grade bulbs was much higher in drip irrigation as compared to the other methods. From the experiment, it was also found that water saving was 39.9 and 38.1 in drip and 27.7 and 36.5% in the sprinkler system in case of onion and garlic respectively as compared to surface irrigation. Establishing 1 acre drip irrigation system requires an investment of approximately 60 to 65,000 rupees. In case of sprinkler system, 25 to 30,000 rupees are required to install the system for 1 acre. DOGR has organized training programs on micro irrigation in onion and garlic for farmers as well as agriculture officers from various states including Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. With so much to gain, micro irrigation techniques are fast gaining popularity in onion and garlic farming. Most farmers in the country have already reaped a rich harvest of success by switching to these cost-effective irrigation methods.
The kanda jo ami ha lavlela ahe ha thibak sinchanavar lavlela ahe tar ya system chi mahiti amala kandalasun samshodhan kendrache sanchalak lavande sahebankadne milali tar tyanne sangitle pramanane ami yachatla antar thevla 4 फुटाचे बेड तयार करून घेतले आणि त्याच्यावर 2-2 लॅटर टाकल्या आणि 2 फुटावर ट्रिपल टाकून ही सिस्टीम बसवून घेतली. तर हिचा मुख्य फायदा आम्हाला असा झाला आहे की ह्याच्यामुळं चांगल्या प्रतीच्या कांद्याचं उत्पादन मिळतं, कांद्याची टिकवण क्षमता वाढते आणि हलक्या जमिनीतसुद्धा, म्हणजे आमची तर ही जमीन अगदी खळकाळ मुरमाड अशी आहे, याच्यामध्ये काही पिकं यायची नाहीत फ्लडच्या पाण्यावर, परंतु ह्या सिस्टीममुळं ह्याच्यातसुद्धा आम्हाला चांगलं उत्पादन मिळाले. आता मी गेली 3-4 वर्ष एकरी 18-20 टनाचं उत्पादन ह्या सिस्टीमवर घेतो आहे. तर ह्या सिस्टीममुळं आम्हाला पाण्यात आमची बचत झालेली, त्याच्यामुळे आम्ही दुप्पट क्षेत्रावर कांद्याची लागवड केली. शिवाय दुसरं असं झालं की खताच्या मात्रेमध्ये सुद्धा बचत झाली आणि चांगल्या प्रतीचं कांद्याचं उत्पादन मिळायला लागलं आणि मग त्याच्यामुळं आमच्या कांद्याच्या टिकवण क्षमतेमध्ये वाढ झाली. आणि अगदी ज्यावेळेला भाव असेल तोपर्यंत, अगदी नोव्हेंबर डिसेंबरपर्यंत आम्ही आमच्या कांदा चाळीमध्ये ह्याचा कांदा साठवून ठेवू लागलो.
The government of India has introduced several schemes to provide financial assistance to farmers who wish to opt for micro irrigation. The Union Ministry of Agriculture provides subsidy for using these systems under centrally sponsored schemes. The subsidy component is up to 25% with a cap of 4 hectares for drip and 2 hectares for the sprinkler system. Under another scheme, the central government provides 40% financial assistance to farmers opting for micro irrigation, while the state government chips in with 10%. The rest 50% of expenditure has to be borne by the farmer. The popularity of micro irrigation has been on the rise in recent years. Sustained efforts by the Directorate of Onion and Garlic Research have contributed to its wide acceptance amongst farmers across the country. Micro irrigation has come as a boon to the farmers battling decrease in productivity because of various factors, including the ever-increasing water shortage. If you are a forward-looking farmer who still battles with low and poor harvest, understand the call of the hour. Switch to this scientific method of irrigation before it's too late. Use water judiciously, not just for yourself, but also for the wider cause of humanity, and get a far better and larger harvest in return.